With the fourth industrial revolution changing the world as we know it, healthcare does not fall far behind. As revolution goes, artificial intelligence, or AI, seems to be the war cry of this one. The idea of creating machines with intelligence equal to, or at times even surpassing human intelligence, it's always been a part of man's imagination since the last century. Hollywood is a proof of that. Be it Lieutenant Commander Data in Star Trek or the lovable Wall-E, humans keep wondering about what would happen if machines had human intelligence. The idea has influenced literature too. Books such as Stuart Russell's Human Compatible and Nick Bostrom's Superintelligence also explore the possible risks and benefits of AI to humanity. This week, we understand what AI is and its tremendous application to the field of healthcare. Welcome to another episode of Global Healthcare Archives. We look at home automation, chatbots, mobile apps, even our smartphones with facial recognition as examples of AI. But what if I tell you that these are examples of machine learning or ML and not really AI? The terms AI, ML, and deep learning are often confused with one another. So let's take a moment to understand how these terms differ from one another. Let's start by understanding what intelligence actually means. Intelligence comprises the ability to think abstractly and come up with creative solutions to problems, in addition to acquiring and applying knowledge and skills. Not something that Alexa seems capable of as yet, does she? In the strictest of sense, AI is a higher level concept and represents a sentient machine that can simulate human thinking and behavior. Artificial intelligence is therefore trying to mimic human intelligence, and it does this by leveraging machine learning and deep learning. In a perfect state, AI can sense, reason, act, and adapt to its environment. Machine learning is a subset of AI and refers to algorithms which improve in performance as they're exposed to more data over time. The algorithm is able to improve and evolve based on the volume of data that's fed to it without it having to be explicitly programmed for each similar or new data set. Therefore, ML can work only within a narrow focus area for which it's been developed. For example, a machine can be taught to accurately diagnose pneumonia by feeding it a large amount of data on the symptoms associated with pneumonia. However, the machine will not be able to diagnose any other disease such as cancer, as it's technically out of syllabus for it. Deep learning is a further subset of ML and is quite similar to ML broadly speaking. Deep learning performs exactly like ML, wherein it has to be fed vast amounts of data. But unlike ML, the programmer does not need to supervise the algorithm. Deep learning does this by itself. For example, ML can be fed a large number of photos of dogs, and it'll be able to properly identify a dog from any new image or video that is shown. Deep learning, on the other hand, will be able to build the correlation between the images of dogs and the word dog in a spoken phrase, and also the word dog written in images or videos provided. Deep learning has been developed to get machines to learn like the human brain through the creation of multi-neural networks. These networks are able to analyze multidimensional data through a structure similar to the human neural system. DL is divided into three types based on the type of input data mapped. Artificial neural networks map numerical data, convolutional neural networks map image data, whereas recurrent neural networks map time series data. A combination of these three methods are used to create algorithms for healthcare. ANN and CNN are especially crucial to the medical field as they are the main tools used for the most popular application of AI in healthcare, namely the diagnosis of diseases. Let us look at how machines are taught to accurately detect abnormalities in radiological images. A large collection of radiographic images displaying a certain pathology are fed to the algorithm. Then, data annotators diligently outline the abnormalities, thus supervising the learning process of the machine. This is an example of supervised ML. After assessing the multitude of images, the machine has now learned to interpret the images through identifying similar patterns, a process quite similar to how we learn. A similar algorithm has been created by Verily, a research organization part of Alphabet. This program applies ML to screen for diabetic retinopathy and diabetic macular edema, two of the leading causes for preventable blindness in adults. This algorithm accurately identifies microaneurysms to diagnose these diseases at early stages. Wearily has partnered with premier Indian eye institutions such as Aravind Eye Hospital and the Shankar Netralaya for assessing the performance of this algorithm in the real world. The studies have demonstrated that the algorithm can perform on par to not only general ophthalmologist but also to retinal specialist in identifying the cause of the disease. Given the low ophthalmologist to patient ratio in India and in other low-income countries, a number of cases get diagnosed late, leading to increased incidences of blindness. Thus, this algorithm takes a small but decisive step towards democratization of the healthcare environment. Another interesting application of AI was developed by Suchi Sara of Johns Hopkins University. Sara has developed an algorithm called TRUES, which stands for Targeted Real-Time Early Warning System, that identifies the early signs of sepsis and warns physicians to initiate therapy. TRUES is a multi-dimensional algorithm that figures out how to think of every signal in the context of another. For example, it can identify whether the increase in serum creatinine in a patient is due to sepsis or kidney disease. Sepsis and the resulting septic shock can be a major cause of fatality in hospitals, and this algorithm is a major boon for healthcare. Let's now see an example of unsupervised ML in healthcare. Drug development requires a large amount of investment in time, human resource, and money. ML algorithms can be used to optimize the process of drug discovery to predict drug-protein interactions, drug efficacy, bioactivity, and safety biomarkers. The algorithm is fed target biomolecule along with large data on potential drugs and their interactions. If enough data is presented to the model, it can aid the research for a likely drug candidate by identifying patterns within this data. Now that we know about ML and its varied applications in healthcare, let's take a look at what AI is. AI refers to intelligent machines and algorithms that can think abstractly and creatively solve problems, all abilities that have up till now been considered the prerogative of humans. Artificial intelligence is classified into three primary types: artificial narrow intelligence, or weak AI, where the machine performs a single task extremely well; artificial general intelligence, or strong AI, where it can perform any intellectual task that a human can; and artificial super intelligence, where the machine can surpass human intelligence. As of now, we've only been able to achieve weak AI. This can be best represented by the fact that the IQ of Google's AI can be classified at about 47.28, which is significantly below that of an average 6-year-old human, which averages at about 55.5. Whether the achievement of strong AI will create a dystopian future with AI such as Skynet from Terminator, or one where humans use it as a tool to enhance their life, such as Robocop from the movie Robocop, is a question worth pondering. And we personally prefer to take the optimistic view. Which brings us to a very pertinent question: will AI make physicians obsolete? We find this anxiety unfounded. Used wisely, AI would be an indispensable tool for the physician. The one thing that machines lack when it comes to medicine is the human touch. William Osler put forward a vital medical maxim: just listen to your patient. He is willing to tell you the diagnosis. Many times the diagnosis is hidden not in the things that the patient says, but in those that he is consciously eliminating. Machines could perform the routine medical task, reducing medical errors and potentially reducing healthcare costs. This would thus allow physicians to humanize healthcare, a thing that seems to have been lost in this era. On that positive note, we end this week's episode. We'll be back with more episodes of AI and its application in healthcare. Till then, stay safe.